Hello，意思柳如。
Hello.
Okay, I share my screen.
Yep.
Could you see my screen?
Yes, we can.
Okay, thank you.
If you want to start your presentation in presentation mode, you can do that, or just leave it like that.
Hello everyone, thank you for your attention. Today my topic is about using error LiDAR datasets to analyze land graduated land substance. And this is my study area in Larca in the Southeast Spring. Land substance occurred in the Lark at a rate of 10 centimeter per year, being the greatest in Europe, caused by groundwater withdrawal. And here we get four kind of data: LiDAR inshore, GNSS, and soft soil thickness. And this is a geological map in Lark. And this is a vertical velocity map derived from LiDAR and derived from INSHA. This is the correlation and the differences between LiDAR and INSHA data. And we use the comma space to analyze distribution of error affected by substance rate for LiDAR and INSHA results. And this is INSHA LiDAR and the GNSS at 10 series at this GNSS station. Notice here, the trend is opposite. This is because during 2009 and 2011, here we built the new buildings, these new buildings. But INSHA and the GNSS data is from 2011, so it's reasonable. Their trend is opposite different. And this is a certificate of comparison between GNSS and LiDAR and LiDAR and INSHA results. But here, we only compare the LORC and the ORC stations. This is soft soil thickness. And this is the relationship between soft soil thickness and the physical deformation rate. And this is cross access analyze between the different results. We can see the ground deformation rate derived from LiDAR, INSHA, and GNSS has a greater agreement, but they have opposite trait with soft soil thickness. And we can notice here, there are many LiDAR outliers. Some is because like this. This is LRC station. We can see here. This is totally is totally different because of the building. This is our flow chart of LiDAR process. First, we merge different LiDAR and registration. Then we filter non-ground point clouds and resemble the different point clouds. And here we find many flat lines. So we use different cell heights to remove the flat line and then calculate N3C2 distance, get the differences. During this process, there are many uncertainties. The first one is the cell height uncertainty of point clouds. The second is the residual non-ground point uncertainty. And the uncertainty in point cloud comparison also will influence the results. That's all. Thank you. This is my presentation. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much, Liru. Very nice. All right. So questions. I've got to get back to participants. Anybody? So Liru, that's. You know, It's really hard for us old people to actually make out some of the labeling on the diagrams. So you gotta pity some of us. At any rate, anybody a question, scientific question?
I'll ask a question, Joe.
Yeah, okay.
I don't think I heard you say, is this being done with a commercial LIDAR?
Yes, this result is from the commercial LIDAR. So here I met many nurses. So before I ask the professor, William, I don't remember about the noise, how to remove the noise.
Yeah, right.
Okay, so Andrew's got a question. Andrew, you want to unmute yourself?
Hey, Andrew, I think you can unmute yourself now.
Oh, well,
okay. Yes. So I, with the images that we are seeing, I wanted to know whether they are ground-based LIDARs or it is a satellite image that we are observing.
Could you speak again? Maybe I...
Sorry, is it a LIDAR or a satellite?
LIDAR satellite, yes.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah. Yeah, that was the GNSS. What is that, Luru? Because you talked about it, but you didn't.
GNSS.
Yeah, is that global?
GNSS is global. GNSS is like a GPS.
Okay. Yeah.
This is the thing.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. All right. Well, thank you.
From William.
I think the last question was, where is the LIDAR located? Is it on a satellite or where is the LIDAR taken from?
This LIDAR is located in this area LIDAR. Is but this is a commercial LIDAR and this is processed LIDAR. So what I get is not the real data. So I met many noise. So I ask you how to analyze the noise.
I see where you're coming from. My answer is I don't know.
Thank you.
Okay. Thanks very much, Luru.